Would you like to know if your favorite amplifier has enough power to drive the Credo speakers you're about to buy? Or are you upgrading your amplifier or moving to a new listening room and you're wondering what kind of power rating you should be looking for? Well, we at Credo have you covered with tips and recommendations based on solid facts and figures. In this video, I want to give you an overview about what you should be looking for when it comes to the amplifier speaker matchmaking in terms of power. Now, this is not an in-depth tutorial, and some of the terms might be simplified just for better understanding. And on that note, let's jump right in. Let's start with the basics. We base our recommendations for a quiet amplifier power on the 85 dB SPL Dolby standard. This standard is widely adopted in the professional audio circles, especially for home theaters and cinemas. Why 85 dB? Because it is the sweet spot where your ears can enjoy all the details without getting blown away or blowing out your speakers. But there is more. Did you know that we don't hear linear? Watch the video to the end to learn how sound pressure affects the listening experience. For a reference home theater setup, we aim for 105 dB peak SPL at your cozy owner's seat. For high-end audio, we're talking 83 to 85 dB continuous SPL with peaks hitting 103 dB. That is like sitting in the front row of a concert. However, in the real world, it will typically be lower at 78 to 80 dB. Now, how does that translate to the speaker amplifier matchmaking? Take the EV Reference 1 at 3.5 meters listening distance paired with a well-known and measured amplifier. For our reference level of 83 dB with 103 dB peak at 3.5 meters, the required amplifier power is 8 watts RMS and the 425 watts peak. For a reference level of 78 dB in a smaller room with 98 dB peaks at the same distance, the required power is 3 watts RMS and 135 watts peak. So how do we come up with these recommendations? It is all about using the right tools and some calculations. And if you want, you can get there too. Let me show you some resources you can rely on. One great tool is the Credo audio calculator. Here you can input your values. The listening distance, 3.5 meters. The desired SPL at listener distance, 85 dB. And the loudspeaker sensitivity rating, let's say it's 89 dB. And in this case, no amplifier headroom. Let's hit calculate. The required amp power is 5 watts. Another handy tool is the calculator for Ohm's law. This is useful for understanding the electrical aspects of your system, like how different voltages translate into watts depending on the impedance of your speaker. Using such tools helps us provide you with accurate, reliable recommendations. Whether you're designing a new system or upgrading an existing one, these resources make sure you get the foundation, the basics right, if aiming for the best performance. And if that seems too theoretical or if you're ever in doubt, remember that our technical support at Credo is always here to help. Establishing reference listening levels is not very tricky, but it is an important fact to pick the right amount of power output capabilities. You can load an app on your phone or use a meter like this. Then you can adopt an industry recommended reference SPL used in mix and mastering studios, or you can find your own preferred reference SPL. Both are valid in a private environment. The Dolby approved standard is 85 dB SPL for each speaker, chosen because it is in the middle of the flat portion of the Fletcher and Munson curve, giving an acceptable listening level for most people. Wait, what curve? Ever noticed how music sounds different at low volumes compared to high volumes? That is what the Fletcher and Munson curve describes. Their curves show that our perception of loudness changes with frequency and volume. At lower volumes, mids sound louder, while at higher volumes, the bass and treble come alive. It's like your ears have their own volume knob for different frequencies. Which brings us to the Harman curve, an important topic in audio reproduction, and much easier to understand once you heard about the Fletcher and Munson curve. The Harman curve represents the ideal frequency response for speakers to achieve the most pleasing sound quality. It is based on extensive research and listener preferences, balancing the bass, mid-range, and treble to deliver a natural and engaging sound. The Harman curve ensures that the bass is deep and impactful without being overpowered. The mid-range is clear and present, and the treble should be crisp but not too hot. When designing our products, we make sure your system can reproduce this curve accurately, ensuring the best possible listening experience. Now, room size plays a crucial role. Smaller rooms can make sound levels seem much higher than they would in larger rooms, due to the nature of early reflections. Consequently, the optimal reference level for smaller rooms needs to be significantly lower. And here is a quick guide. SPL, or sound pressure level, is measured in decibels, dB. To make a hi-fi system sound 3 dB louder, you need to double the amplifier power, because it is a logarithmic scale. For example, if your 50 watt amp isn't cutting it, you might need a 100 watt amp to get the extra oomph. Now here it can become a bit tricky. The published numbers and terms need some time and research. Not only do manufacturers sometimes use different terms like continuous power or program power or peak power, but sometimes the numbers are wrong. Do some research. Some publications carefully test and measure the components that they review. Even though your exact model might not be among them, it might give a better understanding if the brand is publishing reliable numbers. Have a look at soundstage.com or stereophile.com. They publish test results on their website, while other publications measure as well, but you have to check their digital or printed magazine to have access to the measurement results. I'll put a list with other publications in the description. So high efficiency speakers might seem great, but they come with trade-offs like weak bass response, to name only one. Using efficient mid-range drivers and tweeters is relatively easy, but woofers with a low frequency limit will never be more efficient than 90 dB. A passive 2 or 3-way speaker, which is truly linear, full range, is about 89 dB efficient at max. If that efficiency is rated higher, the bass roll-off will come early. And looking back at the Harman and the Fletcher-Munson curve, it is obvious that a bass-shy speaker always will sound off-balance. Are you setting up a new system? Here are some tips. Use an SPL meter to figure out your own reference listening level. Check your room acoustics and consider soundproofing for better clarity. Balance your power. Make sure your amp and speakers are a good match. Dig deep and do some research. Ask an expert like your dealer or the manufacturer. And trust your ears. More watts don't mean better sound. Sometimes an amplifier with enough power sounds substantially better than its competitor offering more watts. Just make sure you have enough good watts. To wrap it up, follow the 85 dB Dolby standard. Understand SPL and how increasing the volume affects the power requirements. Use the Fletcher and Munson curve to your advantage and create a well-balanced system. A speaker with high efficiency might only be an advantage for your amplifier. Properly calibrate and treat your room for the best sound. Balance your amplifier power with your speaker's needs. And that's it for today, folks. If you found this helpful, smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment with your questions. Happy listening and trust your ears.